crazy studio lot. There's just so much history here.
Right?
When five present-day teenagers known as the Kingdom Keepers are thrown into the past, Finn, Charlene, Maybeck, Willa, and Philby open a door into a place and time when the legend of the Disney parks is just starting. They are there in 1955 to retrieve Walt Disney's infamous pen that once saved the parks as we know them now. But like all things Disney, nothing is as it seems.
And joining us live from New York is St. Louisan and New York Times bestselling author Ridley Pearson. Ridley, thank you for joining us.
Hi, thanks for having me.
For sure, for sure. First question I just want to ask you, for those who don't know the series, where did that whole idea come from?
I went into the parks one night, and on my way out, none of the Disney characters were coming with us, and I thought, what happens when we all sleep, and what would it be like if five teenagers sneaked into the park only to discover that the Disney characters were real and had their own lives and their own challenges?
Oh, what a creative idea.
So the five kids get in there and they battle the Disney villains to keep the bad out of the parks.
Yeah, that's a very creative idea, Ridley. You're speaking to your hometown here, so can you kind of give the St. Louis people a glimpse into the Kingdom Keeper series for maybe those who aren't familiar with it? What's new?
Yeah, so the series as a whole takes these five kids into adventures in each of the Disney parks, on the Disney cruise ships, and finally in Disneyland, trying to keep the villains from wrecking everything. And in the new book, The Return, Disney at Last, the kids have found a way to get back to 1955. So you have these 2017 kids with their phones and social media, and they end up in 1955 with none of that. And they actually have to talk to each other and work together to try to get back to present time. At the same time, there's a story taking place in today's Disneyland of a girl trying to help them get back and to keep the evil out of the parks on that end. So it's this interweaving of the two worlds and the idea that we have to work together to get things done.
So here's a question. What is it like for you to kind of have to keep up with all this technology to make sure your books are on cue with the way things are?
I am a techno freak. And on top of that, Disney allows me into their parks something like 32 times now. After dark, after hours, and I get to sneak around when no one's in the park, and I go on the rides when they're shut down with an expert. They tell me all about it, then they turn it on, and I get to ride a ride 3, 4, 10 times by myself and put that into the novel. So I think one of the reasons that the series is read as much by adults as it is by kids is because I bring you backstage and into things you couldn't possibly see unless you got in there after dark with me. So it's been really fun because they've given me an access that nobody ever gets.
All right, thanks very much. We appreciate you being with us. Good luck with the new Kingdom Keepers book. And we're all rooting for you in St. Louis, that's for sure.
Go Cards!
All right, that away. All right, Ridley, thank you.
He has that down for sure.